Gosh, it's getting worse. You won't believe this. India's COVID cases second only to the US. And India's the third country in the world to record 3 lakh deaths. Oh my, listen to this. Parents succumb to COVID, leaving children orphaned.
Oh, that's terrible. By the way, have you heard about the Abrahams?
Yeah, COVID, it's sad.
They are unable to find a hospital bed for himself or any of his family members.
Yeah, despite being the Abrahams, all that money and influence, still so helpless.
Abraham was a rich man. He ran a very successful business.
As his wealth grew, his contributions to the church and community grew too. Of course, not all the money he earned was through honest means. During COVID, he earned a fortune by hoarding and black marketing medicine supplies. Probably felt God would turn a blind eye as long as he gave money to the right causes.
Now, many centuries ago, lived another man named Abraham.
He moved out of Ur in Mesopotamia as per the Lord's command.
His wife Sarah bore a son, Isaac. Abraham was really close to Isaac and loved him dearly.
But one day,
Abraham,
here I am.
Take your son, your only son, whom you love, Isaac, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains of which I will tell you.
So Abraham rose early in the morning and saddled his donkey and took two of his young men with him and Isaac his son. And he split wood for the burnt offering and arose and went to the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham raised his eyes and saw the place from a distance.
Stay here with the donkey, and I and the lad will go over there and will worship and return to you.
Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on Isaac, his son, and he took in his hand the fire and the knife. So the two of them walked on together.
My father,
here I am, my son. Behold, the fire and the wood. But where is the lamb for the burnt offering? God will provide for himself the lamb for the burnt offering, my son.
Abraham built the altar there and arranged the wood and bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. As he stretched out his hand and took the knife to slay his son,
Abraham, Abraham,
here I am.
Do not stretch out your hands against the lad. Do nothing to him, for now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me.
Then Abraham raised his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in the thicket by his horns. He went and took the ram and offered him up for the burnt offering in place of his son. Abraham called the name of that place, "The Lord will provide," as it is said to this day, "In the mount of the Lord it will be provided."
By myself I have sworn, declares the Lord, because you have done this thing, and have not withheld your son, your only son. Indeed, I'll greatly bless you, and I'll greatly multiply your seed as the stars of the heavens, and the sand which is on the seashore, and your seed shall possess the gate of their enemies. In your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice.
Not only are we expected to trust the Lord always, but more importantly, obey Him. We must put His will before everything else in our lives. the greatest visible evidence of our reverence of God is our obedience to Him.
I am a doer of God's word.
I will delight in God's word.
I will not bear falsehoodness.
I will not lie.
I will love Jesus with all my heart.
I will love others as Jesus loves me.
I will not be self-seeking.
I will flee evil.
As 1 Samuel 15-22 says, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed is better than the fat of rams. For rebellion is like a sin of divination, and arrogance like the evil of idolatry.
I don't need your money, I want your life. And I hear you say that I'm coming back soon, but you act like I'll never return. Well, you speak of grace and my love so sweet, how you thrive on milk but reject my meat. And I can't help weeping at how it will be if you keep on ignoring my word.